Sad smo došli do najzapadnije točke našeg putovanja po Sjedinjenim Državama, San Francisco na Pacifiku. I evo pogledajte, tu je onaj čuveni zatvor Alcatraz koji je zatvoren odavno, sada samo služi za posjetitelje. Tamo je Bay Bridge koji spaja Oakland sa San Franciscom, daleko u pozadini je San Jose i Silicijska dolina i onda poslovni dio San Francisca s visokim zgradama. Dalje, desno tamo, je povijesni dio San Francisca s onim tramvajem, s onim strmim ulicama i sada prema zapadu najpoznatiji most na svijetu, Golden Gate.
Zlatna vrata, Golden Gate, u svoje vrijeme najveći viseći čelični most na svijetu. A to je vrijeme 1933. godina. Velika ekonomska kriza i naredba predsjednika Roosevelta da most od 2 km bude dio New Deala. Izgrađen je za samo 2 godine, ima 6 traka za automobile i 2 za pješake. Veliki izazov za samoubojice. S mosta skoči u prosjeku 20 ljudi godišnje. Pad koji traje 4 sekunde preživi tek svaki stoti. Do sad se ubilo 1218 ljudi. Dok ovo objavimo, bit će ih još 4-5 više. Postavimo sad most, što ovdje vidimo? Automobil s registracijom bez brojeva samo piše Vukovar. Ništa se na engleskom ne zove tako, Vukovar je samo jedan. Tako upoznajemo Konora Vlakančića, koji je svoje hrvatsko podrijetlo počeo otkrivati tek kad je počela agresija na Hrvatsku.
You have the plates on your car named Vukovar. What's your connection with Vukovar?
My heart is connected to Vukovar. At the time that I bought my new Audi in 1991 and the war was raging in Croatia and Vukovar was out on the end of a stick as the example of either success or suppression of the democratic democracy movement. What could I do? I could not go there and fight because I would have been slaughtered, as I do not speak the language. So I said, I will put on my car for all people to see the name of Vukovar, and it has been large in my life since then. I was married in Vukovar.
Konor Vlakančić želi biti prvi Amerikanac senator Kalifornije hrvatskoga podrijetla. Skromnim sredstvima, ali s dosta optimizma i originalnosti. Svoju izbornu kampanju nosi na svome 15 godina starom automobilu, sklopi bicikl, na njemu izborna parola koja nije toliko u njegovu korist, nego protiv najvećeg favorita izbora gospodina Feinsteina. I onda Konor zamoli nekog dječaka ili osobno vozi taj bicikl po kalifornijskim gradovima.
You're running for a senator. What preparation do you have to make besides bicycles and anti-Feinstein slogans and so on? What else do you have to do for your campaign to be successful?
To have a successful campaign involves, of course, the people. Significant in the process of being a candidate is all of the legal paperwork, registration with the registrar of voters. The success of the campaign...
Do you have to pay to start the campaign?
The answer is actually yes and no. You can pay to have your name on the ballot, or you can gather signatures from registered voters, and to gather enough registered voters' signatures, that is what is called signatures in...
How many signatures?
For a United States senator, it's 156,000 signatures, which is 1% of the registered voters from the last general election, which was November 2005.
Instead, if you don't collect the signatures, how much do you have to pay?
You have to pay 1% of the salary of a senator, which in this case is approximately $3,000.
Okay. What did you choose, signatures or money?
Well, I chose signatures.
Konor Vlakančić ima 62 godine, ali se kandidat za senatora mora održavati u dobroj kondiciji. Pokazuje nam kako je elastičan, kako dlanovima dodiruje tlo. A mi smo ga iskoristili da nam malo pokaže znamenitosti San Francisca.
Many of the hills are so steep that a motorized bus was not functional and the cable car system was installed to provide the public transportation that was otherwise not available.
Sve što je lijepo je teško i ostvarivo. Dakle, htjeli smo se provozati povijesnim tramvajem. Htjeli smo stati u red, čekati sat i 15 dok dođemo do mogućnosti ući u tramvaj i provozati se kilometar dva. I spremni smo bili platiti i cijenu, 15-20 dolara, ovisno mi preko 60 imamo pravo popusta. I slušati čak i ovu groznu glazbu ovdje iza nas. Sve smo bili spremni. Ali onda su nam rekli da se karte kupuju na drugom kraju grada. A za parkirati naš auto 15 minuta je 5 dolara. Sad ga izvaditi iz parkinga i voditi ga na drugi kraj grada i ponovo platiti 5 dolara, mislim da ne bi trebali mi Hrvati financirati Amerikance.
How long is the trolley wait?
1 hour.
A whole hour, wow. Okay, well,
will you wait for 1 hour for the trolley?
I don't know. Is it worth it?
Of course it is.
It is? Well, I guess we will. It's an hour wait, Barry.
What?
It's an hour wait. You don't want to wait? Should we just walk it? Can we walk that hill?
That's
better to walk? Oh, well, we'll walk it. Okay, we'll walk.
So what do we have here downhill?
This is called the crookedest street in the world. It was built as a tourist attraction to provide visitors to San Francisco a focal point. It is a place where everyone who is a visitor must go to. In the distance, straight down the street, is Coit Tower on the opposite side. This is a landmark in San Francisco where when ships were arriving from fishing, they would raise the flags of what boat is arriving so that everyone in San Francisco would know that their husbands are returning safely.
And today, no more flags?
No longer required. Someone uses a cell phone.
Or radio.
Or radio, yes.
E, doista, ova vas ulica ošamuti gore nego dva dupla viskija.
Nije San Francisco uvijek bio ovako atraktivno i rekao bih sretno mjesto. Prije točno 100 godina, 1906. pogodio ga je razoran potres u kojemu je što od rušenja, što od požara poginulo 3000 građana. Šteta je bila 400 milijuna ondašnjih dolara. 240 tisuća ljudi ostalo je bez krova nad glavom.
And what about this church?
St. Francis of Assisi, originally built in 1849, a much smaller edifice of what you see, was largely destroyed in the earthquake and fire of 1906. The walls remained, and as we reconstructed, it is now, as the National Shrine of St. Assisi's, it is the pro-cathedral of the Archbishop of San Francisco since 1998.
Evo sada u 21. stoljeću kako radi stari tramvaj, koji je istina obnovljen nedavno, ali je sistem isti kao prije 100 godina. Gura se ljudskim pogonom. Tako se okrene dok dođe do žice. A onda ide uzbrdo, sajla ga vuče, kad dođe na ravnicu, stane, isključi sajlu, ukrca putnike, iskrca putnike i onda se opet prikači na sajlu i vuče se u brdo. Mislite li da samo hrvatski građevinski poduzetnici varaju sustav? Čujte od Konora kako to lukavo rade Amerikanci.
The Transamerica building is San Francisco's most recent high-rise. It was built at a very controversial time in the 60s. The protesters had managed to prevent its construction for 6 months, and very clever developer had hidden a bulldozer on the day that the judge was to make another injunction to stop the construction unless construction had already started. And just then the developer had the bulldozer start to dig a hole for the basement, and the judge said, okay, you must build a building now.
San Francisco je središte američke gay scene. Procjenjuje se da je svaki treći par homoseksualne orijentacije. Došli su iz svih dijelova Amerike živjeti u ovom izrazito liberalnom gradu. I to ovdje više nije tema koja otvara društvene polemike.
What is your attitude toward homosexuals and lesbians?
I realize this exists. It's certainly not for me. I am more than tolerant of it because I realize that this is difficult for such people. They are choosing a lifestyle that is contrary to what is the norm. And this is America. America needs to compensate and provide for such attitudes, but at the same time, America is a very heterosexual country. The validity of marriage, it is an institution. It goes way beyond a lifestyle.
How would you describe yourself, as a conservative or a liberal, or in between?
I'm genuinely conservative, but I am pragmatic conservative.
Većina Amerikanaca hrvatskoga podrijetla reći će vam da su konzervativni. Gdje god smo po Americi viđali Hrvate, bili su bliži konzervativnim republikancima nego liberalnim demokratima. Posve suprotno mišljenje vlada među Hrvatima u Hrvatskoj. Anketa Hendala, 500 ispitanika iz cijele Hrvatske.
Tko vam je bliži kao politička orijentacija u Americi? Demokrati 80,8%. Republikanci 19,2%.
Dakle, hrvatski Hrvati bi glasovali za demokrate u ogromnoj većini. Američki Hrvati više vole republikance. Sad smo u Chicagu. 15. kolovoza, točno 100 godina Hrvati slave ovdje Veliku Gospu. U prvim redovima Antoni Perajca, kandidat za predsjednika Cook Countya, to je županija Chicago. Perajca je kandidat republikanske stranke, vodi u svim anketama, a republikanci nisu ovdje pobjedili već 40 godina.
Dakle, ako ovo uži dio grada Chicaga, a ovo širi county,
da,
to bi bila županija.
Tako,
znači,
je.
Vi se natječete za župana Chicaga.
Ja se natječem za župana Cook Countya. Županije Cook, koja je druga po veličini županija u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama. Najveća je Los Angeles County, ima 10,5 miliona stanovnika. Cook County je druga po veličini, ima 5,5 miliona stanovnika. To uključuje čitav grad Chicago i svu ovu okolicu koju vidite tu.
Dobro, pakistanske glasove ćete dobiti preko supruge.
To je sigurno.
Hrvatske preko Hrvata.
Da.
Koje još glasove očekujete?
To je jedna mala manjina županije Cook, etnički glasovi većina. Glasova će biti od strane... Ovo je županija Cook, ima najveći broj Afrikanaca, afrikanskih Amerikanaca u Americi.
Mi bi rekli crnaca nekada.
Crnaca,
ali...
da, ovdje se politički to kaže.
Afro-Americans,
African-Americans. Njih je 1.400.000, meksikanske populacije 1.200.000.
Habla español ya?
Un poco. I ostatak je ostatak, u stvari grad Chicago kao sam takav ima 800.000 Poljaka. Više Poljaka u gradu Chicago nego što je u Varšavi. Tako da je ovo stvar jedan mikro...
A narasla vam je Varšava, bili smo lani 2 milijuna ih je.
Jeli, sa okolicom. Znači... Županija Cook je mikrokozam svijeta, u stvari sve etničke grupe, sve rasne grupe, sve nacionalne grupe se nalaze ovdje u Chicagu i Županiji Cook, i to je jedna od ljepota da na obalama jezera Michigan se nalazi jedna takva zajednica, vibrantna zajednica koja je reprezentacija čitavog svijeta.
I koga smo još sreli na proslavi Velike gospe u Chicagu?
U ovoj gužbi gotovo svi Hrvati. Magistar Domagoj Baraga.
U stvari mister. Mister Domagoj.
Znači, ovdje je MR mister.
Točno, da.
A Paraga, je li to nešto s Dobrivojem, jeste li mu vi u rodu?
Ja sam Dobroslavov brat.
Recite mi, što radite vi? Čime se vi bavite?
Ja sam ovdje u stvari u quality control, što je kao inspektor za kvalitetu u jednoj farmaceutskoj kompaniji.
I kad otkrijete recimo da nešto nije kvalitetno, vi prijavite kompaniji ili objavite u novinu?
Prijavimo kompaniji, u stvari se zaustavi proizvodnja i onda se pregleda i popravi što nije bilo u redu.
A po struci ste?
Po struci sam tehničar. Završio sam za kompjutere ovdje, za mreže, networking, ali u biti ne radim točno u toj struci.
Dolazite u Hrvatsku često?
Ne, bio sam zadnji puta prije 4 godine. Dosta je u stvari skup taj put. I imam djece 3 i onda to prilično puno košta. Ali smo uvijek u hrvatskoj zajednici, evo ovdje oko Hrvatske crkve Svetog Jeronima. I sad i ovdje sam jedan od ovih dečki koji red prave. I
vi ste bili iz obitelji, kako su se to zvali, hrvatski nacionalisti i disidenti. Sad kad se napravila Hrvatska, vi odoste u emigraciju.
Pa u stvari ja sam već prije toga otišao. Mi smo bili proganjani tijekom Jugoslavije i bio mi je oduzet pasoš 8 godina. Tako da sam ja još 89. otišao prije nego se ovo sve događalo i u međuvremenu sam se i oženio. Tako da kad je Hrvatska došla sam već ovdje živio i imao obitelj i posao.
Ljubo Kovač, registracija mu kaže otkud je. Posluši, pa dobro, vi Hercegovci morate Mercedese i pisat otkud ste.
Pa to je bila slučajnost, jel? Jer ove tablice imati, to je jedino jedna osoba u Americi, odnosno u ovoj državi Illinois može imati. Niko više.
A u Hercegovini ne možete napisati posluše, morate imati brojeve one, da se ne zna otkud ste.
No, ovo auto, recimo, ako dođe u posluše, ono se može voziti pod ovim tablicama.
Ali tamo u Hercegovini ne možete napisati posluše?
Ja mislim da ne može, da. A ovdje u Chicagu možemo.
Znači, čovjek mora otići do Chicaga da bi napisao posluše.
A izgleda mi tako nešto, jesu.
E sad, Hercegovac i Mercedes, znači li to, a vi znate ovdje Hercegovce, jer svi kupuju njemačke aute?
Pa, dosta japanske auta, ne baš puno njemačke auta.
U Hercegovini nijedan Japanac, a ovdje japanski.
Pa dobro, ovdje Toyota je obično, dobro, ima tu i Mercedesa, Hrvati kupuju Mercedese i BMW-ice i malo skuplje auto, bolje kvalitete.
So what's your name?
My name is Joe LaMonica.
What is Joe doing here among Croats?
My grandparents are from Croatia. My mother's Croatian.
And you are from Sicily?
My grandfather and grandmother on my father's side are from Sicily. I'm from America.
Why do you all Italians speak with this kind of heavy voice, like Godfather?
Because we're from Chicago, and this is how we talk in Chicago.
When today you think of Al Capone, do you consider him a positive or a negative person?
I think of him as a positive person at that time of our country.
And
What do you know about Croats?
I hate to say I know very little of, other than what I hear on the news here in America.
Your name, Joe, how would it be pronounced in Croatian?
Jozo. My grandfather from Croatia, his name was Jozo. But my grandfather on my father's side here, that's Sicilian, also is Joseph. So I'm an easy one. I was named after both grandparents.
Bili su ovdje i sinski alkari. Zanimljivo je bilo gledati natpise gdje se miješaju engleski i hrvatski. Crkva je, više od politike i biznisa, definitivno taj stožer koji ovdašnje Hrvate drži na okup.
Kad se kandidirate za župana jedne multietničke sredine gdje ima puno bogatih, a još više siromašnih, što su onda vaše poruke biračima? Socijalne više ili više smanjivanje poreza kako bi ljudi imali više novca za investiranje?
Da, to je glavna tema. Novac, džepni problemi. Moje tri glavne teme u okviru ove kampanje su smanjivanje veličine županijskog državnog sustava. Tu se nalazi budžet od 3 milijarde dolara, 27 tisuća zaposlenih koji rade za županiju Cook. To je stvarno previše i mi to ne možemo podnijeti. Znači, zahtijevam da se smanji broj zaposlenih kroz attrition, odlazak ljudi u penziju.
Ti su odmah protiv vas koji će biti otpušteni.
Protiv vas jer i oni znaju. Oni su isto poreznici koji plaćaju za sve to. Porez je visok, previsok, i poslovni ljudi i osobe koje su recimo u penziji ne mogu više dopustiti sebi da žive u gradu jer je preskupo. Njihova taksa, porez na nekretnine je veći nego što plaćaju banki za dug otplate svoje kuće. To je prešlo sve granice više.
Zašto
jedna
su kod
od glavnih
vas...
tema, jedna od glavnih tema je pitanje korupcije. Korupcija na sama kao takva košta u ovoj županiji preko 200 miliona dolara. 200 milijuna dolara u korupciji, ukradenog prekovremena, ukradenog budžetnog proračuna, ukradenih ugovora, krađa na masovnoj razini. To se treba ukinuti što prije i to je jedna od glavnih tema za koju se ja borim.
200 milijuna dolara korupcije, to je za vas puno. 5 milijuna ljudi, nacionalni dohodak 25 tisuća, 30 tisuća po glavi. 200 milijuna vam je puno, jel?
200 milijuna korupcije je stvarno puno. Ako vi promislite da za taj novac mi bi mogli održati dvije bolnice koje bi mogle davati medicinsku pomoć ljudima koji su bez osiguranja. U ovoj županiji od 5,5 milijuna ljudima je preko 1,5 milijuna ljudi koji žive u pukoj bijedi. Pukoj bijedi. U najbogatijoj državi u svijetu, u najbogatijoj županiji u svijetu, 1,5 milijuna ljudi žive u bijedi koja ne postoji ni u Biafri.
Tri dana ranije, Anthony Perajica bio je na proslavi nacionalnog blagdana Pakistana. Svi se ovdašnji Pakistanci predstavljaju kao dobri muslimanski vjernici koji su protiv nasilja za suživot sa svim ostalim.
U Americi koegzistira ono što bi rijetko gdje uspjelo. Evo ga, židovski obrazovni centar, usred pakistanske četvrti, tamo daleko katolička crkva. Any question?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You are from?
I'm from Pakistan.
Okay, and you have today what?
Today we have our Independence Day, and today Pakistan will be 59 years old. And you can see all these floats we have. It's going to be a big parade now, very soon, and we're going to have about thousands of people in the parade and thousands of people in the festival. We call it Mela. We're going to have many, many floats, food floats and non-food items over there. Kids going to be in Pakistani dress with the Pakistani flags and they're going to celebrate very happily today.
And you have Pakistani flags and American flags.
Yes, we do.
So you are very friendly.
Oh yes, we are very friendly and like you know, we are the front alive with America in the war on terrorism. And our president, he always be cooperative with the American. And we are the Pakistani Americans. So we have our Pakistani flag as well as American flag together.
And here we have a Christian from Pakistan. How is to be a Christian in Pakistan?
There is some areas we feel and face difficulties and problems. But, you know, being a Pakistani, we are always there to celebrate birthday of Pakistan, regardless of whatever happened with some of our brothers in Pakistan. But we love Pakistan. Pakistan is our country, and we pray for Pakistan, and we also pray for America and for whole world for peace, and that is our dream, and that is we want to see in reality people live in peace and harmony.
So in United States, you are all Pakistanis together, no fractions, no religions?
No.
I'm Muslim. I represent the National Bank of Pakistan. I'm a vice president with the Midwest region.
And with Christians, how do you cope?
How they go?
How do you cope with Christians?
I brought you a very dear friend of mine, didn't I? Because it's important that we don't look on the basis of the religion. I think media has a great responsibility on the shoulder to express the proper relationship between the communities. And I think, I mean, media can do a lot of damage. Media can do a lot of good to it. And just to answer to your question, I'm like, you know, he's one of my trusted friends. Not a good friend, trusted friend. So you can very well narrate, I mean, how the relationship is. Yeah, there are some isolated cases of all over the world.
There's one question, let's see. Here is a Jewish center.
Yeah.
In the middle of this multi-ethnic neighborhood. Did any Pakistani ever went to visit the Jewish center?
I have. I consistently go and talk about the benefits of having open dialogue between Christian, Muslims, and Jewish faith. I serve as a liaison committee member for the Homeland Security and FBI, as well as...
But you bankers, you work with money, you don't recognize nations.
Well, you know, in order for me to keep my money safe, we need to have a safe environment. And the way we can do it is provide a quality life to human beings around us so they can live happily and safely.
So if all presidents were bankers, the world would be at peace.
I personally think, I mean, they will do a better job on a traditional basis, because I have a great respect for politicians. I mean, politics has been changed from last 30 years. But I think if people will be given an opportunity, such as myself, to lead certain areas, we can do a wonderful job, and I have proven that.
No tensions with the American community, with Americans, everything is fine?
As a matter of fact, the Pakistan and Pakistani community are a great alliance and friends with the American community, American society, and American itself. Yes, no tension. I bet all the Americans would like to be a part of the celebration with the Pakistani community. And that's all that matters, the coalition.
I see flags, Pakistani flags, American flags, together.
Yes.
That's normal here.
It's very normal, yes.
Could it be possible in Pakistan to walk in the streets with American flag?
Well, when you have Independence Day of United States of America, and we have American community in Pakistan, any parts of Pakistan, there are flags of United States.
Golda Meir, Hrvatski kulturni centar, svi su pomijeni.
U okviru obitelji, prijateljska svađa. Primjera radi, Pakistanci koji su imali danas dan samostalnosti su bili na sudu jučer, tužili jedna grupa drugu, ko će biti glavni u okviru te parade. Ali uglavnom svi su se pridružili parade, kao što ste vidjeli, i sve je bilo u redu. Tu postoje političke podjele kao i svim drugim zajednicama, ali s te podjele se sve mogu riješiti razgovorom, dijalogom, i to se tako i napravi.
And how is it to be married to a Croat?
It's again, I wouldn't know the difference because we've been married for 27 years, so I can't say it's any better or worse being with somebody else. He's a wonderful husband, great father, and very loving towards me. So
you have three choices: Pakistani, Croatian, and American. Now, in percentages, mm-hmm. How much are you American? How much Pakistani and how much Croatian?
Well, that's hard to say because with both my parents, really, they've always instilled in me a sense of where I came from and culture. So really, I appreciate living here in America. I think it is the ideal place to be. And at the same time, I have the privilege of going to Croatia and Pakistan as well and seeing that side of the world where I came from. And I can't describe it. I mean, it's great to go to those places where your parents lived and they were born and see what they were, you know, what it was like for them, and then comparing it to my lifestyle here in America. And I don't know, as far as percentages, I I'm 100% American, and I have just as much pride in being Croatian and Pakistani, so.
Okay, when you think of Croatia, you have some picture in your mind. When I think of America, I have New York, Las Vegas, and Grand Canyon. So what do you have as a picture of Croatia? What city, what?
Probably Split, I think, in the water, just being out there in the beach and fishing and the beautiful landscape there. Also, we went to a national park, Plitvice, and it was amazing there. I don't think I've seen anything quite like that since I've been there. So I just think of the beautiful scenery and the people and friendly faces.
And what's wrong with Croatia?
What's wrong with it?
Oh, be honest.
It's too far. It's too far away. I wish it was a little bit closer. I'd go there more often then. That's about it. So.
Ovo smo snimili kod jezera Michigan. To je glavni izvor vode za Chicago i okolna mjesta gdje se u široj regiji smjestilo 9 milijuna stanovnika. Sam grad Chicago s blizu 3 milijuna građana treći je po veličini u Sjedinjenim Državama. Taj grad prodaje godišnje roba i usluga u vrijednosti od 400 milijardi dolara. To je sve što stvori cijela Hrvatska u 10 godina. Naš Toni Perajica, ako pobjedi na izborima, imat će ogroman proračun. Ti kontrasti na svakom koraku. Sad ovaj kanal, ova rječica, sve to izgleda mirno, pitoresno. Ovdje se ovaj most trese, ja odskakujem, zato što je iza mene promet koji ga stalno vibrira, a ovdje iza je najviša zgrada u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama, Sears Tower u Chicagu. Najviša od kako su srušene bliznakinje Svjetskog trgovinskog centra. To je taj simbol protestantizma. Čovjek zgradi zgradu što više u nebo, da bi bio bliže Bogu. Tako oni vjeruju. Kod katolika je posredništvo preko crkve. Što veću crkvu pomogneš izgraditi, bliži si Bogu. Chicago je indijansko ime. Ovdje je živjelo pleme Potawatomi, koji su naselje nazvali Chicagan, a to je značilo divlji luk ili češnjak. Bijeli kolonizatori uzeli su to ime za rijeku, Chicago River, a onda su tako nazvali cijelo mjesto. Središte grada nije samo neboder do nebodera, kao u većini američkih metropola. Posljednjih godina centar je oplemenjen mnogim kulturnim i zabavnim atrakcijama. Ali nisu dirali u staro. Naš Meštrović ostao je tu sa svojim Indijancima. Ima 100 načina kako na vrućini popiti vode na ulici. Ovo je klasičan. Nije hladna, ali nije ni topla. Puno bolje osvježenje bi čovjek dobio ovdje na 80 i nekome katu gdje živi kolegica Opra na nekih 1200 kvadrata. Ovo je jedno od utočišta, ali je stalno prebiva u Chicagu. Bili smo i u Crnačkoj četvrti na 5 četvornih kilometara nijednoga bijeloga čovjeka. Osim nas, koji smo se čak drznuli tu prespavati u jedinom hotelu. I što se ne bih usudio prije 20 godina, čak smo ih intervjuirali. Ovaj gospodin sigurno ne izgleda opasno. What's your profession?
I'm a paramedic in Chicago.
So you work with these emergency cars. You are a doctor?
Yes, well, along the lines of a doctor.
So when it comes to a car accident, you're the first one to go there?
The first one to go there, and what we do is we advise the hospital and the doctors, nurses, or whatever, what, you know, they have coming in, so they'll know how to treat a person.
In Europe, the emergency cases are taken on the street basically always by doctors, and in the United States is paramedics. Are you well trained to assist the wounded people?
Yes, I've been doing this for 12 years. So here in Chicago, well, Illinois, United States, we usually have the trained professionals go, you know, to the scene or what have you, and then we treat the person, and then we'll take the person to the hospital, and then the RNs and the doctors are there on standby.
You work and you live in a black neighborhood of Chicago. You would know firsthand. Are there more accidents, more shooting, more criminal cases here or in other neighborhoods in Chicago?
Well, that's an interesting thing. Can you hold on just a second?
Yeah, you have a case?
Yeah, my job. Hold on. Hello? On 173rd and Halsted. Yeah. You picking me up? Look, I'm filming right now. Can I call you back in like in a few minutes? Alright. Sorry about
that. What happened?
No, that was my partner coming to pick me up in the ambulance, so you all might get a chance to see the ambulance.
No accident.
No. But okay, getting back to what I was saying. What was it?
More cases here or in other neighborhoods?
Okay, that's a good question because I'm finding out now that there are more things that happen in the quote-unquote rich neighborhoods than it is the quote-unquote black or the white neighborhoods or whatever. So there are a lot of things that are not told on the news, you know, on a day-to-day basis, but you hear that, like, through word of mouth. You know, so I would say that it's probably even.
Davidova djevojka Sara bježi od kamere, ali njezin mlađi brat Tom hoće govoriti o sebi.
Your brother-in-law, you've been listening to our conversation. So do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Everything? Do you think that you stand the same chances if you are working hard?
Yeah.
What do you do?
Accident.
No job at the moment?
No, not right now. I'm finna go back to school.
How old are you?
18.
All right. But have you been working something?
No.
Helping around, working, I don't know, with the shops, doing something. Have you tried?
No.
Not yet.
A black person with a high school education basically have to go through the same thing, you know, as... and I don't really like to use the term white person.
Sorry, Afro-Americans.
No, I'm talking about because I was always raised. I was raised in a house where we were Christian and we were not allowed to use white, black, Hispanic, or whatever because we're all one. You know, I cut myself, you cut yourself, we bleed the same blood. You know, like, you know, my mom, well, we live right down the street. If you wanted to come and eat at my house, I have no problem with that because we're people. So, getting back to the education, we go basically through the same thing because I was the only black male, the black person in my paramedic class that passed out of, I think it was like 20 in our class and the rest were white. And I was the only black male that made it. So... as far as education, it's only life is only what you make of it. If you sit around and don't want anything out of life...
Are chances equal for whites and blacks?
It should be, yes. And if it's
but
not...
It should, but it is.
It's not sometimes, but that's where, you know, you have to fight a little bit harder. Because I'm going to tell you, I stand at about 4'10", 4'11". That's my height. And usually the average paramedic... is about 5'6", 5'7".
David Dean kao bolničar hitne službe ima 60.000 dolara na godinu. Koliko s istim zanimanjem zarađuje naš poznanik talijansko-hrvatskog podrijetla?
You have to live life on what it is.
What is a monthly salary after taxes of a paramedic?
With the Chicago Fire Department, we make about $60,000 a year.
That's before taxes?
Before taxes. Depending how you structure yourself, they might take more taxes out or less.
And you're happy with that?
Everybody wants more in America, but I'm content with what I have.
You have a family?
Yes. I have 3 sons and a wife.
And can you live as a, say, middle class with this salary?
Yes, middle class. probably lower middle class now. That's not a lot of money.
Isti posao, ista plaća. Nije važna boja kože. A sad, jedna znamenitost Chicaga u kojoj smo uživali.
How heavy is this pizza?
Oh, this is... what do you mean, how is it? It's...
10 pounds?
12 pounds. It's 12 pounds, the largest are.
Dakle, pizza od 6 kila.
I'll help you.
And it's fat. For how many people?
That feeds 4 people. That's 2 slices a piece, so... It's a lot of pizza, though. So.
And it's called?
It's called the Pizzeria Uno. It's numero uno, is what the pizza
but
called.
It's a Chicago pizza.
It is a Chicago-style deep-dish pizza, yeah. You want me to help you?
Yes, please. Yeah,
this is how we serve it. Here. So there's the first piece. And the numero uno has sausage, pepperoni, green peppers, mushrooms, and onions in it. But all of our pizzas are different. So all of them have different ingredients. There we go. Can I get you gentlemen anything else, or are you all set?
We are fine, thank
good,
you.
Good. Enjoy.
Toliko poštovani gledatelji u ovoj emisiji idućeg tjedna o legalnim i ilegalnim Meksikancima, koliko zarađuju, kako ih hvataju i deportiraju i još mnogo toga. Doviđenja.